Hello everyone, I am today going to be live with Mrunal Thakur. Hi Mrunal!
Hello, how are you?
So I think housework, doing these lovely lives with...
Going on, right? Jhadu pocha and all of that.
You know,
Rudrani, I really respect my mother because she does it every day without saying a word. And, you know, today I realize the value, you know, she does it without complaining. And it's really difficult. It's not easy at all. I think we usually take things for granted, you know, the fact that of, you know, going out, meeting friends, you know, 2 days, it's fine, but more than 2-3 days, you can't stay at home. But now it's for good. You know, I'm happy that, you know, the lockdown has been announced, and I'm happy that people are staying home, taking precautions. Although there is immense panic going on right now because a couple of people want to travel back home and there's no public transport that they can travel in. So things are getting better. Just hope that, you know, people take precautions, yeah, because once it starts, you know, COVID-19, it's going to get awful if we don't take precautions. This is the first time I'm going live like this, you know, it's insane.
It's interesting.
I was still trying. Yeah, and I'm also like a technology challenge person, so I really don't know how it functions, so I was really palpitating.
You're doing well. Would you like to start off by saying hi to everyone who's joined us?
Yes. Guru Raj, my brother Mandar, who's live from inside.
Hi, Mandar. Bhas
Guru, Snehil. I am unknown. Wow. This is quite some username. Karus. Hello, Karus. I am Diljeet. I am Shiva Singh. Anu Bellara. Hello, guys. Hi, Simranjeet. Yeah, there you go. There are many. My God.
I'm going to start with a few questions and then we will continue our conversation. We got a question from Aryan who said that, can you please share with us some funny moments that happened with you on the set of your upcoming movie, which is the Jersey remake?
There are so many funny moments. Oh, there was one, you know, there was a scene with Shahid, and, you know, I really adore him. I really look up to him. And in that scene, I had to slap him and I just couldn't do it. But, you know, the first slap went right here. Everybody started laughing and I was palpitating and people are looking at me on set and like, is Keto, matlab, she's really scared to even like slap him. And how do I slap him? Yeah, like, I had to forget that, you know, guys, we're shooting a scene and I really have to like pull up my socks and go for it. And he's so supportive. Shahid is really very, very focused and he really helps me. Shahid made me feel really comfortable. He's like, it's okay. Even I'm struggling, you know, it's the initial days. So don't worry, you know, things are going to get better because, you know, once we start living the journey, it's going to get easier for us to get into the character and perform. And eventually, I think... he's fun, yeah. He knows when it is musty time and he knows when it is work. He's so focused and God, he's so, so, so talented. I'm really happy that I'm sharing my screen space with him because I have like Pankaj sir with me and Shahid on the other side and they both are like such fantastic performers. And I feel like I learn a lot by sitting at the monitor and watching them.
You know, have you been a cricket fan? Is that because I know the film, obviously his character.
Yeah, now since Virat Kohli is married. But, you know, I mean, who wasn't crazy for him, though, you know? I remember wearing the jersey and going in the match and with, you know, with my brother, watching the semifinals in Mumbai. It was fun, like, just cheering like that in the stadium. And I don't believe I'm doing a film which is based on cricket right now.
Tell me about your character. Tell me about what's very interesting about the character you're playing in Jersey.
There are a lot of things, you know. Like, first of all, the story is so good. Rudrani, when you watch that, you know, when I saw the scenes, the original film, and I just fell in love with the emotions and the graph. And I don't really cry that often, yeah, but I had those tears and it was so inspiring. So see, my agenda is whatever work I do, I should just be, you know, be associated with the film, which kind of inspires you and kind of wakes you up. You know, just for example, there is a lot of challenges going on now on Instagram. You know, I challenge you to do this, I challenge you to do that. And what I do is I just tag my friends and just tell them that I am not challenging you, I'm just inspiring you. Agar aapko karna hai to karo, nahi karna hai to mat karo. So that's the thing, you know, I just want to do something that is inspiring and people should just feel like, are yaar, ha, there's something in it, you know, that something is in me too. And why am I sitting here? I should also just like step out and do what I'm good at. So I'm really happy because through these characters, you know, I learn a lot of things. Not just Jersey, but, you know, to begin with, Love Sonia, Super 30, Tufan. Yeah. It's been an impeccable journey. I'm really, really enjoying it because every day when I come back home, I learn something new.
Before I talk about Tufan, because you mentioned it, I must say, does it feel surreal? Because today you're getting the kind of roles that you always wanted to, working with the kind of people that you always wanted to.
Yeah, it feels like a dream or something that I already dreamt of. The best thing is that, you know, when I'm doing some work, not because, you know, it's quarantine and lockdown periods going on. In general also, when I'm just cleaning my house, my dad comes and looks up to me and he's like, oh, she's the star. Look at her cleaning the house. I said, so, Papa? You know, he's like, I still don't believe it. It's the same person who I see on screen. I said, yeah. कल को पता चले कि मुझे सीन में झाड़ू मारना है, so I should be able to do it now. So yeah, but it feels like a dream, yaar. And I still don't believe it's happening. I mean, we almost finished we finished shooting Tufan, and Jersey is like almost 50% done. So and another film that I'm doing with Sony, you know, Aankh Micholi, that's also ready. So all these years I've worked hard and it's finally paying off and I'm really happy about that. I have to tell you, every day my routine is like wake up, clean the house, and it's all divided. Like my brother is designated to do a certain kind of work. Sister does something, dad does something, mom does something. Although my dad is working and he's my superhero, yaar. You know, such period, you know, he's a banker. And I feel like bankers are not really appreciated, you know. So this is a big shout out to all the bankers who are still working, making sure that, you know, they're taking care of our economy. And also the securities, yeah, the watchmen and everybody, they are nonstop working for us, making sure that we are safe. So kudos to you guys.
I know that you all were, Farhan and you all were shooting when of course this happened and they put out the entire message. So could you tell us about that?
Yeah, so like 1 day before the 2 days before the lockdown, it was supposed to be like a holiday and then shoot. So the team decided, because the situation was getting worse, we preponed the, you know, the shoot, and we made sure that we finish it in one go itself. It was easier because, you know, you never know who's traveling, who's coming, how, you know, people don't have the luxury of traveling in cars and Ubers and stuff like that. I don't know how they come. So I think it was very important for us to wrap the film as soon as possible so that people can just like be at home and not be the carriers. Yeah. You know, I might not get affected. I'm really young. And even though I have, I might just recover because my immunity is strong. But when you come home, there are lots of different age group people, you know, you might just give it to them. So I think I am home since March 1st, I guess. 1st or 4th, yeah. So I'm happy that we at least smoothly finished. Although Josie got stuck. But it was not like 8 days work that you will quickly finish it and get done with the film. It was a big chunk. So we decided to just like give a break and not wait for something horrible to happen and just, you know. So we just flew back from Chandigarh to Bombay.
What have you been observing in these lockdown days around people? Would you like to tell the ones who are even planning to a little bit, you know, change their mind about not practicing social distancing?
They'll get one tight slap from me. Sachi mein. And you know, I feel like we celebrities, we are influencers, okay, in a way. And I saw, like, I would not like to name that person, but she went, live from Instagram where she said that I'm going on a mini vacation and I'm so happy I'm stepping out of the house after 10 days. And I immediately wrote down, I said, dude, you have 5.4 million followers and you're not supposed to mislead your followers. And they would be like, you know, just because she's stepping out, it's okay for us to step out. Like, I was checking out a couple of PAPs, you know, Instagram, social networking sites, and I saw actors still traveling. My heart was like, God, I hope they're safe, first of all, and because people look up to us. So it is our responsibility to, you know, take precautions and stay home and, you know, not step out. And I think that was a bit too much.
Why don't you tell them as to the kind of skills you're picking up or, you know, what you're trying new? And what's interesting happening in your life and you're keeping yourself busy during the lockdown?
Yeah, you know, Modi sir said that you need to do social distancing, not emotional distancing, you know. You need to stay at home. You can talk to your friends thanks to FaceTime, thanks to, you know, Instagram and all these live things that you can go from. Have you even considered helping your parents? Because I feel like they go through a lot all day. I think setting and downloading those apps and some party apps, I have no clue. You know, people are asking me to join those. And I was like, guys, I have a lot to catch up with. I am so happy to have conversation with my parents, to cook dinner for them, you know, to peel garlic.
What did you last cook?
Oh my God, last cook, fries. Like my brother who plays Fortnite all night, he loves fries and that's the midnight craving. So he's like, Didi, I want to eat some fries. And I'm like, okay, there you go. So sweet potatoes and yeah, that's.
Farita Anjun, 787 is asking you, your favorite actor?
It's Shah Rukh Khan. Anytime Shah Rukh Khan. I really want to work with him. And I've been dreaming also about him. It's quite funny, though.
Really?
You know, like, so on a cute movie set. And another favorite actor right now, recently I'm binge-watching, you know, is Keanu Reeves. I really adore that man. I mean, that man has inspired me to do some action movie. Like, I really want to do something, like, full-on action and with guns and stuff like that. You know, so this haircut was inspired by Naomi Scott because I really loved her in Aladdin. And then I was like, let me just talk to this girl. She's so pretty. And then I found out she's half Indian. And then I saw she just went like this short. I was like, okay, I want to do something. For Tufan, I want to go this short. I want to change the inhibition. I want to change everything. Heroine lambe baalon mein aati hai. You know, blow, wo sab hawa aati hai, baal urte hai. Mm-hmm. Let's get practical.
You know, you mentioned Tufan, and would you like to tell them about what your character is like? And of course, we know that, you know, Farhan is playing the role of a boxer out there.
Although I'm not supposed to talk much about it, but I'm just going to say that she's a very liberal girl. You can make out from her hair.
Yeah, and, love it.
Yeah, she's liberal. She's a person who would always say, right is right, wrong is wrong, you know. Don't mess with me. And it's something different that I have done. Yeah, I haven't done this before. Like every day for me was magical on the sets. On my way back home, I would just look at the sky and be like, this is the kind of satisfaction. This is the kind of work satisfaction I wanted. And it's happening. And I just can't wait for the audience to see it. It's very different being directed by Rakesh Om Prakash Mehra. It's, you know, it's a, I mean, I'm so, so happy. I think I'm really blessed. And Farhan is fantastic too. I am like so blessed, yeah, to have like working with Farhan and Shahid and Ritik and John. I'm really, really happy.
One more question. And this is what this person says. The person is Yash. And is asking, what Yash. Do you think about Shahid? Just one word for Shahid Kapoor and the entire experience. I don't know how it's going to happen, but let's see. Mrunal, do you want to take that?
Oh, wow. I think it's fabulous. It's fab, like, you know, right from the director, my producer, Gautam and Aman and Shahid, they come together as a team and they're like a family and they understand what's going going on with that person? Is that person, you know, so, you know, there was this particular scene which was scheduled, and I thought I was not ready for it. And emotionally, also performance-wise, it was not coming. You know, then you start judging yourself that, shit, yeah, will I be able to do it? Will I be not able to do it? Am I capable of doing it? Then you just feel like you're in so much pressure. But not all producers do this, but this Aman, you know, he's such a fantastic producer. He just went on and he said that, Mrunal, you want to do this scene later sometime? And I was like, do I have the option to? He said, yeah, we can reschedule it. And he's like, let's do it. I was like, I'm so thankful because I get that much time to prepare. You know, when you watch a scene, like a 2 minute, 3 minute scene, it just goes like that. But when you have to shoot it, oh God, it gets, although it was difficult for me because I was juggling between two projects. I was doing Ankh Micholi and Josie, and it was really difficult. Yeah, I don't know how actors do it. Trust me, it's really difficult when you juggle two characters from here and there.
So how do you sort of come out of it? Like if you're, you know, you're doing something for Akme Choli and then you have to go back to the other character. What do you do to sort of maintain that balance?
So I like listening music. Okay. So I don't know. I just select one song for one character. It might sound a little funny, but this is how it works for me. I select a song and I keep hearing that song over and over again. The criteria is that the fact that the lyrics of the song should match the journey of the character that I'm playing.
But that's fantastic. But yeah. I think everybody has their own process. This is the part of your process.
Yeah, but I have seen Farhan doing that too. Like if there is an emotional scene going, you know, which we're going to supposed to shoot, he would just sit on a chair with his headphones in his ears and he would just be like listening to that song. He would just perform and I would just keep looking at him and I was like, wow. Like I was crying because he performed so well and I'm not supposed to cry. But after the scene, he's like, fine, huh, what's up? Yes, it's amazing how he does it. Yeah, it's an art. Not everybody can do it.
Avinash Spark made a very sweet comment and I just happened to see it. They said that he loved your acting in Super 30. And
thank you, Avinash.
About it, but Super 30 did get you a lot of love, didn't it?
Yeah, Super 30 was magical too. It was amazing. It I think ladko ke mamlo mein hamara choice bahut acha hai. That was something that stole people's heart, I feel.
Favorite South Indian actors? So I'm sure
Prabhas, yeah, he's such a I mean Bahubali, of course. I think who doesn't have a crush on him? So yeah.
That is kind of true. To end it, thank you. I think I was having so much fun, but I know you'll also have to go ahead. I'm having so much fun. We must do this soon again.
Yes, let's do that
and,
again.
I'm feeling so positive talking to you. To end it, would you like to talk to everybody here who's been here? Tell them how to stay positive during this time, how to follow social distancing and, you know, still be happy and utilize the most of the time.
See, guys, you know, apart from India, there are a lot of countries who are still functioning. You know, they are still working. They are still out. You know, the best thing about this lockdown is the fact that, you know, we are safe. We are away from corona. And I think now the other countries are regretting it too, you know. So let's appreciate this thing, you know. Let's stay home. Let's take care of ourselves. Because all we want to do is just for this virus to end. I'm really happy that, you know, the families are coming together, please spend time with your family. Don't just sit inside the house, in your room and just watch, obviously maintain the distance, but try to have a conversation because that keeps you, that wouldn't make you depressed. You know, if you'll just sit in your room and just be like, you'll not work out, you'll not take care of yourself. Obviously anyone is going to feel low and little, you know, depressed. So don't crib, guys. It's for your betterment. I just want to say this to people that whoever your staff is, you know, work at your place, just make sure that you give them ek do mahine ka salary in advance because they also have to stock up their house, you know. So I made sure that my staff is they are safe and they're stocked up, and you, trying to donate, you know, PM CARES fund, you know, Narendra Modi. I've been following Narendra sir, and it's like he, there's a lot of updates about where you can donate. Make sure that you donate the right account. Yeah, and just be home, yeah, because police are like struggling for the crowd to stay at home, and they come out saying that, oh, I was feeling low, so I just stepped out. That's not the reason, guys. Just stand in your balcony, in your window, take the fresh air, and just be at home. Don't be the carrier. I have to specially mention about, you know, Joginder Sharma. He played I think T20 World Cup, and now he's serving as the police. So hats off to Mr. Sharma. I'm so like happy that, you know, players like cricketers are serving and taking care of the nation.
No, absolutely. Thank you so much, Mrunal. Lovely with you always. You know, it's, I think all of us feel a little bit more positive. I'm sure all of you are feeling more inspired. As you see, like you said, make most of your time. Thank you for joining us. Yeah. Thank you, Mrunal.
Thank you.
I'm going to talk to you soon. Take care. Bye.
Yes. Arjun, bye.
Bye.
Bye.